Friends, let's now discuss some area percentage related problems. While discussing this topic, we must be clear about the basic formula of mensuration, that is areas, circumference, perimeters, all that, okay? Volume, okay, if the case of 3D figures, okay? So first of all, we have to identify the number of variables in each for each quantity. In this case, suppose it's an area. Now, area of a rectangle, there must be two variables, okay? That is length and breadth, okay? Suppose I take the example of this is a rectangle, and same will be the case with square, okay? Suppose I take the example of circle, then there will be single variable, that is radius, okay? So radius r. Now if I talk about area of circle, that will be pi r square. That means area of circle is proportional to square of radius. And if I talk about circumference, then it will be 2 pi r, okay? So for every quantity there is a relation. Here the relation is between area, length and breadth. Here the relationship between area and radius. Here the relationship between circumference and radius. Or suppose I take the example of a cylinder. The volume of cylinder is pi r square h. That means there are two variables. That is the radius of the cylinder and height of the cylinder. Okay. So similarly, various examples or various quantities are there in the mensuration topic. Okay. In all the cases, first of all, that means the very first step is to identify the formula and its variables. Okay. Let's take one example. First of all, let's take the very simple case of area of a rectangle. Now, what is area of a rectangle? Area A is equal to length into breadth. Friends, initially we must assume the variables to be 10. Okay, doesn't matter it is a rectangle and length and breadth must be different. Okay, since in the calculation of percentage change, it doesn't make any difference. So let's, the length is 10 and breadth is 10. Then the area will be 100. Okay. Now, if there is any change in length and breadth, we'll be getting the change in area immediately, as the base is 100 only. So we'll be directly getting the percentage change. Okay. Now suppose length and breadth, both of them are increasing by 10%. So what will be the new length? It's 11. And what will be the new breadth? That is 11. And what will be the new area? That is 121. So initially it was 100. Now it is 121. So difference is 21. Okay. And the, since base is 100, directly we'll be getting the answer in percentage. So it's 21% increase, since it is an increase. Okay. So it becomes very simple if you start with the base 10. Okay. Now suppose in other case, suppose I increase the length by 10% and increase the breadth by 20%. Then what would happen? Initially the area is 10 into 10. 100. Now I'm increasing the length by 10%. Then the new length will be 11. The new breadth will be 12. If I'm increasing the breadth by 20%, so it will be 12. Now what 11 into 12? It's 132. So what's there? It is 32% increase in the area. Isn't it very simple? It's really a fun and it's really easy if you know this logic. Okay. Now suppose I increase one of the quantity and decrease the other quantity. Now the area is 10 into 10, 100. Suppose I increase one of the quantity by 10%, I'm making it to 11, and I'm decreasing the other quantity by say 20%. So it's 8. Now what is that? 11 into 8, 88. Now initially the area was 100, now it is 88. That means there is a 12% downfall. Okay, isn't it very simple? So you can play with the variables accordingly. Okay, now suppose the area is 100. I'm increasing one quantity by 10% and I'm decreasing the other quantity by 10%. So it's 99. It's 1% decrease. Okay. So friends, if both the percentage is same, that is increase percent and decrease percent is same, that is x, then in all there will be a x square by 100% decrease in the net value. As in this case here, 10% increase and 10% decrease, that is 10 square by 100% decrease, that is 100 by 100, 1% decrease. So you can directly put this logic. Okay. Now in case of rectangle, whatever is increment or decrement in the variables, you can easily find out the percentage change in area, isn't it? Now let's do the problems which are given over here. Let's take them one by one.